Hi everyone, welcome you back for the sessions on the acceleration sensors and the gyro sensor. The first thing is we have to know what is the accelerometers. Now accelerometers are used to measure the vibrations. That too especially it is also called as the vibrometers. These vibrometers are also used as something like a seismic monitors or maybe the inclination sensors or it may be a motion sensors accordingly. Or according to the what we can say the sensitivity and also the frequency response characteristics. These are so called as inertial sensors where the linear accelerations or it may be the vibration shocks or it may be a tilting angles, it can be measured very easily. Now here in this case, a single crystal silicon cantilever and a proof mass and a doped piezo resistors as a sensing elements. Now here, as we know that the development with respect to the polysilicon surface machining technology, the analog devices pioneered the polysilicon surface micromachine accelerometers based on the capacitive sensing methods. Now, it is initially developed an accelerometer, the products based on the capacitive sensing and also the principle and later introducing with respect to the other methods. The low G's, that too especially with respect to a 20 G's that deals with respect to the motion of the human can also be generated and also be measured. The accelerometers with a high acceleration ranges deals with the industry and also the military applications. The awareness of the accelerometer technology by the public increased tremendously. There is a new rush with respect to the companies entering into the arena of the acceleration sensing and also the companies exploring a new principle and a new packaging technology and a new electronic functionalities. The electronic sensors seems to be a more widely used. There are two reasons that the piezo resistors are generally doped with the top surface of the mechanical elements it can be measured out of the plane motion. As such, the ability of the resistors to be measured in a multi-axis acceleration is limited. Now secondly, the capacity sensing the circuitry and as well as the rather maturing the provided a good sensitivity is also another parameter. The acceleration sensors and the gyros are increasingly used in conjunction with the sensors and performing with a wide variety of the functions including the energy savings, the medical emergencies and monitoring and precision operation. The design consideration, as you know that the successful design of the acceleration or the accelerometers must be taken into account with respect to the following aspects. As you know that the mechanical designs includes the with respect to the dimensions and as well as the mass, the chamber pressures and also the other parameters. The selection of the material that also plays a major role in the fabrication of the high yield and as well as the reliability and also encapsulation of the technology in packing. The achieving the cost and also the profit goals by considering the compatibility with the high volume packaging in the manufacturing system. These factors are the strong interaction with each other. Now here in the sketch it shows that there are three parameters. One is with respect to the design space, the another one is with respect to the fabrication space, the another one is nothing but the material space. All these three put together is nothing but the design of the component. If you take an example with respect to the design space, there the program interface, the dynamics, static mechanics, the control and the digital circuits, these it has to be designed in such a way that the size it should also be very compact. In the market space, the what we can say the pressure levels or it may be the stress levels or it may be doping levels, these it has to be considered over the sensors and as well as the actuators. Now considering the static model of the sensors, upon giving the acceleration of A and with the inertia force of F, which is represented by means of F is equal to ma, that causes a static displacement where in order of ma by k, where k is nothing but the spring constant and c is nothing but a damping constant. The next is nothing but the gyroscope. As a gyroscope is used to measure the angle of rotation speed. Now the gyroscope is used to be a high cost low volume product. intended only for the high-end applications, such as in the case of the guidance in the military uses. That too, especially these gyroscopes are having a major application in the aerospace industries and also in the naval industries. There are several principles such as the measurement, including the optimal and also thermal. However, the most of the common methods is based on the coronal force developing the moment of the object. In 2010, the digital cameras, optical image stabilization market is developed. Because of that, what we can say, the gyros as gyros is also advancement technologies is also increased, whereas on the other hand, the pictures taken with a low light consideration and also the zoom lens are subjected to the hand movements. Now, gyros are a very sensitive to any potential manufacturing vibrations, the packaging stresses and the linear acceleration and the changing in the ambient temperature. The coronal force. We can explain with respect to the coronal force and as well as the measurement below, which gives the mm with the velocity, the new velocity v, and as well as the rotational framework with the rotation speed omega and magnitude. The coronal force fc is equal to minus 2m into omega v sin alpha. Now, this can also be explained with respect to the tuning fork. Now, here in this case, if the tuning fork is heated, the vibration, what it is taking place, the FC, and also this vibration, it should be exactly 90 degree. Now, the commercial cases with respect to the gyro. Now, the sensors are also a very small, which is nothing but consumes a very little power. These sensors are used especially in the case of the gyros. The sophisticated electronic devices, which includes a 16-bit analog to a digital converter and a programmable digital low pass filters and the temperature considerate bias adjustments and also the application program interface for the use of the systems. It is also incorporated with an embedded temperature sensors and also the integrated oscillator for the clock. Now, even the Cosmos chips is bonded directly on the top of the MEMS wafer using a eutectic bonding to the aluminium layer of the Cosmos wafer. The schematic diagram shows the gyroscope configuration. The bottom one is nothing but a Cosmos wafer, which is also called as a complementary metal oxide semiconductor, over which transistors are placed, and then even the gap is placed, which is nothing but creating a vacuum cavity. Now, a suspension mechanical element is placed over the gap where the beam and the MEMS wafer is placed. Because of this, the vibrational movement or the tilting angles, it can be found out very easily.